Hello, my name is Norberto.
Norberto!
I see a lot of younger people here. I'm 18 and I've been going through a hard time, so I'm only here for like 10 minutes, but hearing your guys' poem is pretty joyful. Mine is not going to sound that joyful. So here I go. This is called Selfish Joy, and I wrote it. I hate being alone at night because the darkness surrounds me the most like a blanket in the cold. It doesn't keep me warm anymore. The only thing that keeps me warm at night is the torn apart heart struggling to survive. I ask myself, do I feel like living today, or do I feel like dying today? Because some days feel like they never end, and those days are the days I suffer the most. And I wish I had met my salvation at the end of the 45 I talked to in my sleep at night, but the days where the sun shines on my face as the clouds disperse, this familiar feeling of love comes back to me. When I thought I had lost everything that was dear to me, these familiar faces walk towards me and ask me, how was my day? How has my day been? And have you got over her yet? Because my friends and my family are the only things that keep me alive. And ever since February 14th, 2018, the only reason I'm still alive is because I strive to keep other people happy, so they won't go through this depressed feeling of sadness and anger that consumes me at times. So thank you to everyone I've ever made smile. Thank you to everyone that came to me for their problems, because how many people ever came to you when they had problems? Seems like the only people that can solve problems are the ones with problems. And I know it's selfish to say that I gain my happiness from seeing other people smile, but at least I will know that that was because of me. So thank you to everyone that's ever felt joy because of me.
I love this torn apart heart that just really felt right. And the familiar faces walking towards me, you didn't say familiar people, but the faces, because that's what we look at. And the fact that you can give joy to somebody in the middle of pain. And if you, if anybody has heard of this book called The Prophet by Khalil Gibran, should read that. And he talks about love as sorrow. It's called The Prophet. And he says, your joy is your sorrow unmasked. Meaning that you are always within sight of joy and sorrow. So you're not happy all the time, you're not in pain all the time. But the two of them are almost brothers. One is sitting at your table while the other one is lying on your bed. So I think this is what your poem did. Thank you. And who's up next? And who's going to be coming after this lady? Okay, sorry. What's your name?
Mahima.
You can do this. Mahima!
If not now, then when shall we bloom from our tortured root, from the shed of the innocent? Our stems intertwine, just like our souls, we grow and see, for we share the same way. Our minds tangle together, much like inseparable, our leaves embed one another, as if in a tiny bird. Our petals ever so gently caress, dancing on the soil. We sway side to side, teasing the wind before it fails to knock us down. As a tortured root that comes out of the rising dew.
Mahima! Yes! Give it up! Thank you. And I love the tortured root, so that we go from the pain to the beauty, which is all, this is kind of what you're talking about too, Roberto. So there's this duality coming from torture but coming into beauty. I'm probably going back to torture somewhere.
I like the fact that you go from darkness to colour as well in that poem. I can't find it very well. I really love that. That was beautifully done. Well done. Who's up next? Come on up.
Telling me I don't enjoy things I used to love. Telling me I'm not good enough. Putting me down every time I feel some confidence. Ruining all my relationships except ours. You bring out the demons, let them take control. The angel is no longer on my shoulder, telling me the right thing to do. Who have I become? Surrounded by family, I now consider strangers. Let's disappear and lose contact with everyone. Do I really feel like crying every time I wake? You fooled me. You're the only one I fight with daily. You make dying feel comfortable, but I won't let you win anymore. You're still there, but I've got a bit of me secured in the back of my breath. Never felt like I needed to be saved by anyone except myself.
This is very hard to do, but you guys are coming out here and putting your hearts on pages. It's incredible. The friend I don't want, tell me I'm not good enough. Who have I become? All that doubt, that's amazing. We all go through that. We all question ourselves. It doesn't matter who you are, how successful you are, or how not successful you are, you're constantly doubting yourself. So we need a copy of that of our computers, of our laptops. That was really cool. Thank you. Alright, so who is up next? There's loads of you standing around. Who else is coming? Come on up. No? Waiting for somebody else who's hiding. Okay. Do you want to read from over there?
Come on, Jared.
Oh. What's his name?
Jerry.
But you can't, we do the whole chorus for you. I mean, we just, you know, give our hearts out to you. You have to.
How about Mireia?
I'm sorry?
Mireia.
Mireia? Mireia? Where's Mireia?
Do you want
to read from over there?
I'll pull it up.
Okay. See, Fernando has your phone for you. Jimmy, are you really going to, is this guy even going to dump us? We get, you know, we were so in love with you, and then you just like, kicked us to the curb.
Battery died.
Huh?
Battery died.
All right,
battery
so
died. Yes.
No, I put new batteries.
No, they died.
Oh,
there you go.
Yeah.
You're kidding me.
Victor!
It dies.
Right, so I wrote this poem about a year ago.
It might stay. I got a short poem.
One day felt like two when
Come
I was
on and do what they can.
2 days felt like four. It was like you already had 1 foot out the door. And 6 days passed. Oh wait, it's only been three. Did you feel the same way or was it just me? It was just me. You were still as happy as could be. 4 days or eight. I wasn't feeling great. My heart was about to break, and every day I felt it ache. 5 days or 10. When will this pain end? I wanted us to start so we never had to end. I scratched your back, and you stabbed mine. You caught my heart at the time when most girls just caught my eye. Unfortunately, I just couldn't catch yours. We went our separate ways. One of us found love, and the other fell in love with the people around me.
Victor, yeah! I like the way that you use numbers to build this into your poem. You start with one, became two, and then with It seemed like four, but it was only three. So we don't have to act as a four.
I'm shooting already.
Losing time. When you're in love with somebody who doesn't, who's been there? Who's been with a love who doesn't love them? Oh, it's only me. And, okay, there's two of them. So the three of us, we can form a club. That's very cool. Thank you very much, Susan. All right, so next up, guys, coming up. And what's your name, sir? We'll take it slow. What's your name?
Name's Calvin Klein. Let it shine. He's a friend of mine. I'm a slogan. You okay. Can't remember names. I don't know.
Let's give it up for the slogan guy.
I'm old, 74, written like maybe 2,000 poems, and I'm supposed to pick one. This is my biggest book. It's like a New York Dictionary phone book.
It's a brick.
All the girls I've ever loved are in there.
Use Mike. Put your mic to your mouth.
I don't like these. But anyway, Orlean. Yeah, I have four daughters, but this is my dancing daughter. We've been dancing together all this since 2000. And now her daughter and her grandkids, her daughter and grandkids are living in my house. Anyway, I picked one, I guess. Where are you? Oh, no. I am old. You can tell that. Okay. Anyway, this one's Any Measure of Glory. I'm a rhymer. I don't do free verse. In fact, some of the free verses that I have done, I went back and made them rhyme. Because there was a line missing, the couplet. I do couplets. I believe in rhyming. I think they're the best poems, the most creative poems. You have to look at it. They do have a beat, a count, a number. Anyway, let's see. Our flame but an amber, our light now dim and distant. I tried to move my muse, but she was cold and distant. She was jealous, not of you, but of him. Not a good sign. I do believe in signs and voices and destiny's design. God doesn't create our future. He knows our future. We have the power of choice, but sin is in our nature. Some souls don't believe in sin, but they feel the guilt. Some don't believe in God, but they feel the pain to the hilt. Then they know God when he heals their inner pain. There's no atheist in a foxhole. War is but a brain strain. But in the rebellion, he returns to his foolishness of doubt. He doesn't believe nor knows what the Bible is about. I met two atheists in Vietnam, two atheist Marines in Nam, but both of them died. One dying, Jesus saved me. The other, her mama cried. But I saw no mama, but I saw Jesus in my opium stupor, sober enough to visit the Nang Chapel and the Savior. He saved me from many close calls with death knocking. Bullets, bombs, honky pits, snipers, all doing their thing. But I was guilty living while my buddies died over there. So with each poem I write, I honor the sacrifice for me. They will be remembered if I attain any measure of glory. Yeah, that's a shorty.
Okay, guys, give it up, Calvin. Thank you. Yeah. I'm talking about redemption from a really dark place and coming to your life. That's amazing to make that transition over and over again after seeing things. So, thank you. Alright, next up. Everybody, you know, we're still looking at you. You're not getting away with this. We feel terrible.
Okay, you'll go. You said
go. You'll go. Alright.
He's being voluntold.
Why not?
I have it right here.
Come on. Jerry! Yes! Sorry, you're not friends! Yeah!
No, that's good. Now I can't take a picture. Though.
I'm a little nervous.
It's alright. Just hold it closer. A little higher. Wait. Jerry, tell
me. This phone is called Old Ways.
Closer.
I used to think what my parents told me was true. They taught me every belief of their religion. When I got older, I did not believe everything they said. They tried to show me life from their point of view, now I see it through mine. Belief and prayer only help to a certain limit, then you have to help yourself. Praying might help your mentality, but you won't get done the things you want done. The experience your parents have had might not affect you the way it did to them.
Jerry, all right. Shame to be so. But it was. I thought what was really cool about your poem, Jerry, was the fact that you are learning truth for yourself. I like the fact that you went through, you know, you accept what your parents say. When you're little, that's your whole world, right? And then suddenly you realize things are really different and you have to go through that yourself. And you have to, there's no one but you to help yourself. That's excellent. Well done. All right, next up. We've got lots of people here. You know, if you don't get up, you're going to make Fernando get up and read. He will never stop. So, you know, you have to spend time doing something. Anyone else going to come up?
Go for it, come on.
Hannah's standing up, would you read her poem? Come on, give us some love. Hannah!
Friends aren't always perfect, but a friend is someone we turn to when our spirits need a lift. A friend is someone we treasure, for friendship is a gift. A friend is someone who fills our lives with beauty, joy, and grace. A friend makes the world we live in a better and happier place. Thank you guys for being my
friends. It's all the things that I work with.
Yeah.
That was cool. Let's hear it for Hannah. Hello! 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 What struck me is we hear poems about friendship. You started with this really cool line, friends aren't always perfect. That's such a great way to start because you know, we expect so much from our friends, and they're not perfect. They say stuff at the wrong time, they insult your hair or your shoes. They say the wrong stuff about this really cool, you know, pair of jeans that you just wore, or they don't even notice that you're wearing something really cool. So your friends, you know, they can laugh when you want them to be sympathetic. I've done that. But your friends are there for you, whatever. And I think this was just such a cool poem to bring out. Thank you, man. And thank you for dedicating to who you were. That was really lovely. All right, guys, who's next?
I am next.
All right. Wow.
Nice to hear it.
Hi, Teresa.
Can we hear it from Teresa? Teresa!
Hi, I'm here now because I'm reading. I've been here since 7:58 in the morning.
Woo.
So, any of you know what an anagram is?
Yes.
All right. So, this is really impromptu. I was setting up back there. And so I go, okay, so everyone has a spelling of letters in their name, right? Some of you have really long ones, some have short ones. So, I have six letters in my name. Whatever came to my mind when I walked up to here, I said, okay, Teresa, T is for tall. Not so tall, but I'm tall in here.
Yes.
E is energetic.
Yes.
Anyone guess how old I am?
25.
Times 2 plus 15.
29.
R is responsible. I am a widow. I'm responsible for two children.
Yeah.
And every time I think of that, I get teary-eyed. We all have chance to be responsible. E, special. E, especial.
Yes.
In Spanish, there's no S, there's no word that starts with S. Especial. I treat myself as special
because I see everyone in here who took their time to come.
Yes.
To be special.
Yes.
A. Amorosa. I love to dance. So, that's it. T-E-R-E-S-A. When you go home today, write your name. That is going down. You can do this way and that way or diagonal. And that's my poem for today. Thank you.
You've got one more person coming up? Come on up.
Adriano!
I knew I should have changed the shirt since I wasn't. Okay, so I guess I'm knowing my audience here.
Adriano?
And is the reason for what you live or what you lead, giving birth as a mom, or working your tishah as a dad, I am the highest expression of their life. They live to ensure not just that I'm okay, as their point in their fusion of their life, and not in a narcissistic way, but that I love completely what I die for. And what other purpose is there in life than to love with abandon? Love pouring, streaming, water, fudge,
yes,
uninterruptedly from the moment you lay eyes. Maybe some words during nurturing might sound correcting or a little not the best, for no one is perfect, but the underlying constant, the thing that's the default, what's always there, your intent, your engaging, your entire physical length, your body has eyes, beam out your heart, your entire body is open, skin closet open, revealing your organs, veins, skeleton,
yes,
sacred heart all the time, but walking via those muertos.
Yes.
Here I am, and you are here.
I mean, I wasn't expecting this stuff to come because, you know, we're just chatting about, you know, how, what does it mean to be the center of someone's life, to be adored like this? And then you moved into, this is your purpose for living. This is love with abandon, this streaming love that your entire physical lamp, where did you get this? This is the chain. And your skin closet is open. I love that. That's incredible. Well done. Thank you. Have you had any more?
I definitely want to go to some point.
I'm sorry?
I'm ready at some point. They're printing their
poem. Oh, somebody's printing their poem, right?
There's three of them.
There's three people. Oh, so three people are coming. Do you have anything?
Okay. I want to practice.
So let's hear it for this young man at the front, Fernando. Fernando!
How's everybody doing out there? I'm really nervous. You guys, is there anybody here that's just so nervous that they won't come up? Raise your hand for me. Okay.
Yeah.
Here you go. That's two. I'm going to do this for memorization even though it's not memorized. Is that possible?
You can do it.
First off, let me just say that you guys are very lucky to be here because of people like me. And what I mean by that is, have you guys ever used a microwave oven?
Yeah.
All right, well, I was one of the first people to use the microwave oven, so I was one of the test subjects. And that's what this poem is about, okay?
Really? That's true? You were one of the first people?
I think so. I'll explain it right now.
Okay, all right.
What hardworking Chicana wouldn't see the microwave oven as a divinely inspired, miraculous invention to relieve the modern day woman with three jobs of her obligation to cook for five kids, four living grandchildren, and a traditional machismo viejo. So for about a week, we became the scientific test subjects of the physiological effects of 10-cent frozen burritos on the human body. And if it wasn't for my extremely paranoid Pio Pancho and his conspiracy theories, my grandma would have never had to make another meal on the stove. Is population annihilation? ¿Sabes qué? The CIA is selling the inner city crack. It's population control. ¿Sabes qué? The AIDS epidemic, it's chemical and biological warfare genocide. It's population control. ¿Sabes qué? I haven't seen any cockroaches in the kitchen since you got that microwave oven. If the cockroaches are laying low, it may be time to let that thing go. It's probably population control. They're trying to take out Chicanos first with their microwave burritos and chimichangas. Then it's gonna be Native American Indians with microwave popcorn. It's probably gonna be the Italians next. Just wait. There'll be a microwave pizza in every freezer in LA. I can't even watch the game without that thing humming its death song. Oh look, radiation is messing up the reception. It's probably population control. You saw this kid? It was bad. The aroma of homemade tortillas and Folgers coffee at 5 a.m. The sound of my stomach grumbling. Waking up to papas frying in chorizo, huevos and sizzling in tablespoons of butter, pink beans boiling with a dash of salt, a cube of pork, onions and garlic, and my grandma slamming the cabinets to make sure she wasn't the only one awake before sunrise.
That's here from Fernando. That's amazing. Thank you. I love this, the conflict between the generations and the conspiracy theories.
There's new ones now.
And there's new ones. And the humor using voice as well. So that even though poor Abuela has to do all the work, there's a sense of longing for something real, for something homemade, as opposed to just the microwave stuff. So very cool, thank you. And have our photocopying people finish. Are we ready?
Still don't see him.
You still don't see him? Okay. So anyone else in the meanwhile? Have we got somebody else who's coming up? You want to do number two? Oh, okay, so Jonathan, come up for number two, and Calvin, come up for number two. That'd be great. Let's hear it for Jonathan.
The library, under a sky so blue. The library, but with the notes and lights too. The library, a towering mountain with a hidden fruit. Knowledge, a long-lasting, ever-expanding root. The library, step foot and you'll see. What adventures will await you and set you free.
That was weak. Come on, Jonathan. I love that the library sets you free. That's very cool. And the hidden fruit. That's kind of sexy, isn't it? And the joy of sinking into another world, another person's emotions, I mean, all that stuff we get from reading is so cool. So next up is Calvin's going to do number two for us. Come on, Calvin.
That's what I call a real poet.
We're all real poets. You guys are all real poets.
I got no memory. I'm a stroke victim, and I got that as an excuse. In my first poem, I used the word muse. The very first muse that I ever had was my grandmother, Kika. So I'll bring it to you. muse. I got 2,000 poems, and most of them came from out there somewhere. And I heard the voice, I heard what they had to say, and I was basically a dictate. I would dictate what I heard. Still do to this day. Anyway, Kevin Swing. Uncle, why didn't you tell me Grandma was Indian? Yes, and we never held it against her. That's his reply. Kika, a Native American, a term forbidden, never to be spoken, never a proud grandson's side. I knew Grandma was special beyond the family name, beyond being blind and able to see the unseen. All the kids would kneel before her, our blessing to claim. Beyond the Catholic cross, she was our holy queen. That became our Sunday ritual, just like going to Mass. We knew our sins of youth were not the simple venial kind. I had tried to kill my brother, and there was sex without class. I was a thief and a liar, and the wickedness I could find. And she would bless me longer than the other siblings, as if she knew my sin and bent and had vowed to save me. One of five, she tried to pace the brother's strugglings, but I remained broken even though she forgave me. In Nam, I heard her voice and her spirit always with me. I could have died many times, but she was my shield. Like, duck, or don't go any another step forward. I heard her voice. The bullets, the bombs, the pits, they had the common theme. Death's futile effort for blessings would not heal.
Just a little bit more.
I will always remember Grandma Kika's passing as she lay on her deathbed, still blessing all who came. I knew one last time, I knelt one last time before she went to her king. I saw the glow above her, surely was heaven's flame.
Kika.
Yeah. I love the fact that Grandma was Indian, but you never held it against her. It was really funny. And I love the fact that she was able to see the unseen, and that followed you into now and protected you. She was your guardian angel.
You
were
my guardian angel.
Yeah, thank you. Okay, come on, guys. Who's going to read? Okay. Come on out.
Come on, Alicia.
Give it up for Alicia.
My poem is called "Don't Trust Nobody." I know I'm young. I don't know much about life, but what I've lived has been rough. Because everyone around me, I can't trust whoever's close to me is untrustworthy. Trust doesn't last because we're in change and trust is creation. So therefore, I have to worry about who I trust. It's the number one key into my life.
Yeah. Good job. Thank you, Alicia. That's such a critical thing to learn about trust, isn't it? Because we trust them blindly when you're kids, and then somebody does the dirty on you, and you suddenly realize you can't trust anybody. So I think that was a really crucial poem to write. Thank you very much. All right, guys, anyone else coming up?
Come on, come on.
You can do this. Yeah, let's hear it. Yeah. This is Maria. Maria, welcome, Maria. Yeah.
My poem is called "If You Only Knew." I can't afford, if you only knew, I can't afford class materials. I'm getting bullied at school. I feel like I'm in a hole with no escape. Sometimes I'd rather be at home. Sometimes I'd rather be at school than home, but I feel stressed by too much schoolwork. If my teachers only knew, I wish for more support. I want them to care and appreciate my work. I want my teachers to care not only how I'm doing at school, but home too. I want them to know I try my best.
Yeah. hard thing to write about. I think you took such a, you took your courage in both hands and stood up and talked about that. So just to tell you, from somebody who is a teacher, that's our job, to support you, to be there for you. So, you know, do we have any other teachers here? We have any teachers? We've got one. Okay, this is your responsibility now, everyone. You have to take care of everyone. That's your job. Because we do want you to do well in school. We do care about you. So, just to let you know. All right, have you got anything else before we close it? I guess we're getting ready to close it. Yeah. Want to go out and do another one? And who else?
Madam Green, then Cookies and Punch.
Okay, yeah. So let's hear it one more time for Adriano.
"75% water. I am the living water. Strain me, and you shall be revealed. Dependability. Preservation, bondage, relationship is futile without your action, your intent, volition, your choice. What makes me alive, what makes me living, what makes religious words alive, Jesus, the Bible, noble truths, gurus, my revelation, what gives feet to my wisdom is your awareness. Citta, notice. From A to B, for B to B, your appreciation blossoms. B and something to bless, it's B, is a receipt of you. Life retains me because of you. Be humble in your power and thirst responsibly. Give charitably. Your meekness, after all materiality and even my last drop fades, shall inherit you the earth. For all is preserved and all that remains. For you are the salt of the earth."
Thank you. Land like living water. Be humble in your power. It's all we bring this to remember. So can we hear it now for all the poets? That was just
There's
a duo?
Yeah, I think
we'll take
one more.
Come on up.
All right.
Nice. Let's hear it from you. So it's Jonathan and Sibling. Cool. This is great. You guys are going to read today. So Jonathan, I know you, but what's your name?
Tania.
I'm sorry. Okay, let's hear it for Jonathan and Tania. Who am I? Well, where do I start? Anxiety taking constant hold of my heart. I'm not one to frown, but that's because one knows I've been taken down and torn apart. With only myself to finish this deprecating piece of art. And I can't tell anyone where the truth ends and the lies begin. I can't tell you anymore, so where do I start?
Where in poet?
Into the unknown. Into the unknown is where everybody moves, the place that can be scared. Into the unknown is where I wander. Everyone strives in knowing of what is to come. Fear and markings as we go deeper into the unknown. A dark place with no light except for the one on you. The doors appear and then you fear not knowing what the right path is to choose. Hesitation sets and anxiety builds. Then you think, what if I make the wrong move? All you can do is embrace the fear and continue head on. You choose a door, there you go, into the unknown once more.
Yeah.
Let's hear it, Jonathan and Tania. That's just very, you know, the fear of the unknown, the questioning of the identity,
anxiety taking hold of my heart. This is just great stuff. You guys are amazing. All right, let's hear it for all the poets. Somewhere over there, right there, behind the balloon. So help yourselves, talk to the poets, tell them how fabulous they are, and see you next time.
Thank you, Sam.
It's kind of impromptu. For anyone that likes ice cream, today is a free Ben & Jerry's day.
Whoa! Where's the nearest Ben & Jerry's?
I'll look it up. Collection.
We need to go, right?
The collection.
Well, we'll do that and we'll donut friends.
Free ice cream.